Hello, it's me, Santi. So a lot of you requested me to do a tutorial on cloud slime, but I thought it'd be interesting to test out different products to make it. So let's start off with the base recipe of what I used. I don't think there is a specific type of slime that you really need to make, just as long as it's super thick. So I added white PVA glue, regular soap, lotion, and then I added my coloring. So it's actually okay if you overactivate your slime because it does tend to thicken up your slime, and that's exactly what we need. So something like this is perfect. The first product that I'm testing out is called Super Absorbent Diaper Polymer, and the instructions say just to pour some liquid over the powder, but it doesn't specify how much of each should I add. So I just stirred out with 1/3 cup of the powder, mixed in with 1 cup of water, and then I waited 2 minutes just like the instructions said. And after 2 minutes, it became like this slush gel texture, which I believe is the same gel that's used in diapers. And then I mixed that into the slime, and I noticed that it definitely softened up the slime. So right away, you can definitely see it resembles a cloud texture. However, the more I play with it, the more I kneaded it, it just started to rip easily, and also it doesn't stretch smoothly, and it kind of just became a mess. A lot of residue comes out, and I think what happened was it absorbed too much of the slime. So I thought adding more slime might help it, but it kind of just became an ugly mess. I tested out another batch made with just 1 tablespoon of the powder, and this is what I get. So as you can see, it definitely stretches better and much smoother. However, it does not look like a typical cloud slime at all. It's more stringy. I do notice that it does leave a lot of residue, and you can see it in my bowl and on my hands, especially when I play with it. In this batch, I made with just 1 teaspoon of the powder, but as you can see, it doesn't really stretch as well, and also does not resemble a cloud texture anymore, and there's not much residue, which is great. However, I don't really like the texture, and I don't really recommend this product overall. Next product that I'm testing out is the infamous Instant Snow, and I think this is what most people use to make cloud slime. Not really sure, but the instructions say to add about 1/8 cup of the powder mixed in with 2 cups of water, but I added less than that. I added about a tablespoon of the powder mixed in with 1 cup of water, and as you can see, it expands to almost 2 cups of snow, so a little goes a long way for this. I mixed that into my thick slime made with the recipe I put at the beginning of this video, and as I kept mixing and mixing, I noticed it got stretchier, and also it's much more softer. So I decided to add more snow because it's definitely not the cloud texture I was looking for. I added the same proportion, and the reason why I'm using such a small proportion is because you don't want to add too much of the snow, or else it will turn into like too much of the snow and it'll start ripping and it won't stretch smoothly. I do prefer my cloud texture to be on the more stretchier side. So I did this about 3 to 4 times until it became my desired texture. And this is the result that I get. And you guys, I am so in love with this slime. This was my first time making it, so of course I was super excited. So I think Instant Snow is definitely the clear winner here. I really recommend it to make cloud slime, obviously. Last product that I'm testing out is called Slush Powder, and the reason why I chose this is because it has similar properties as the previous two products that I tested, in which you need water to activate the powder. So there were no clear instructions on how much I should add, so I just added about a tablespoon of the powder, and then I just added enough water until everything was dissolved and activated. And the texture after it was dissolved with the water is a combination of the previous two products. It has that snow, but also that gel texture. So I mix that into my slime. And as I kept mixing and mixing, it became this texture, which I really like. It's super stretchy and soft. However, the more I started to play with it, it got more sticky, unfortunately. So I did have to add more activator, which led me to think that I used too much of the powder. I wanted to see what would happen if I added more slush powder to the slime, because this is not the cloud texture that I wanted. It doesn't have that kinetic sand feel when you stretch it. So I repeated this about 2 more times with a teaspoon of slush powder added in, and this is what I get. And you guys, I love it. It's super stretchy and soft. It definitely is not that typical cloud slime. It kind of reminds me of Peachy Baby's cloud creams. However, I've never felt them before, so I'm not really sure. Overall, I do quite like this product. However, I don't really know where to get bulks of it, because it just comes in a little container that I got from Amazon. I would love to know, because I do like it. And that is it to this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and I would love it if you subscribe if you're new. That'd be amazing, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!